Members of one of America's most elite fighting units were among those killed when that giant Chinook helicopter went down. A military inquiry may look at just what the Navy SEALs and the other U.S. troops on board were doing there and why. Our Pentagon correspondent Barbara Starr is digging into this part of the story for us. So what are you learning, Barbara?
Well, Wolf, what we have learned today is those Navy SEALs were not on a rescue mission, as we were first led to believe.
The 22 Navy SEAL commandos killed when their helicopter was shot down by the Taliban weren't on one of their usual secret assault missions. Military sources confirmed the SEALs were called in to chase down a group of Taliban on the run. Army Rangers already on the ground were looking for a Taliban leader when some insurgents started to escape. The Rangers didn't need rescuing, they just called for backup. That's contrary to what some military sources said just after the crash when they suggested the SEALs were helping pin down troops. It's all raising questions why so many SEALs were on a single vulnerable helicopter.
They ended up exposing the entire force, unfortunately, to enemy fire. And all it takes is one lucky shot. And that one lucky shot from a Taliban perspective was what happened.
Investigators will also look at whether troops other than the SEALs could have been sent. The shootdown is raising questions about U.S. troops returning to these remote mountains they left months ago. Insurgents have set up new strongholds, especially here in Wardak province, where the shootdown happened.
Many of these valleys were previously held by U.S. NATO forces, but because we have concentrated on more populated areas now, the Wardak areas have actually been given over to the Taliban.
The Pentagon doesn't think the Taliban even knew the helicopter was carrying SEALs from the same unit that killed Osama bin Laden. But commanders asked Defense Secretary Leon Panetta to ban release of the names of the dead men, even though many families have already identified their loved ones. The worry? The deceased names might lead to their buddies on the bin Laden team.
And now, Wolf, you know, let's go back to that 10-year-old little boy who would like the world to remember his father. Leon Panetta tonight is in the hot seat. The covert military community does not want him to release the names of the fallen. They say it could somehow lead to the team members that got bin Laden. But so many families have already come forward publicly. They want their loved ones remembered. Leon Panetta has to make a decision. Does he go with what the covert community wants, or does he stick with the tradition? The Pentagon, to the best of our knowledge, has never, in 10 years of war, failed to publicly acknowledge the names of anyone who has fallen in battle.
Wolf. Well, how can you control the family members who want to express their grief for a loved one? The Pentagon can't tell them. You have to remain silent. You can't say anything, can they?
Well, this is exactly right, Wolf. This is the modern world of communications, isn't it? There are Facebook pages. Families come forward of their own free will. They speak out. They offer the photos, as this young boy did. So many military families want to speak out when their loved ones fall in battle. Many military families don't. They want to keep it private. That's absolutely their prerogative. But the key issue really here is the Pentagon, for 10 years, publicly puts out a statement of the name and the unit of everyone who has fallen in battle. If Leon Panetta decides to break that chain, it will be very newsworthy, Wolf.
Certainly will be. All right. Thanks very much, Barbara.